It's about that time of day again. My name is Joseph. Monday evening, October 29th. Welcome back to your nightly newsletter. My job is to help new traders earn consistent profits using a simple and reliable trading strategy. And my plan this evening is to identify the most reliable trading opportunities setting up for tomorrow's trading session. And tonight, we're covering crude oil, S&P, Nasdaq, gold, and euro. Starting off this evening, crude oil is bearish below the weekly triangle. So I don't want to sell below the range. My plan is to look for buying opportunities, but I have to wait for those sellers to fail on this breakout attempt for buys going back up tomorrow morning. The S&P is bullish after the sellers fail to hold momentum going lower. But I'm sure there are going to be a couple more sellers trying to short this market tomorrow. And my goal is to use seller failure patterns for buying opportunities for a possible short covering rally. Speaking of short covering rally, the Nasdaq finished its session in a bull market with a short covering rally tonight. But I would expect to see a few more bears trying to short this thing tomorrow morning just at the S&P. So we're watching for those seller failures and we're trying to buy into their stop losses to fuel this run higher on the E-minis. Gold is bearish and trading at the low of a range tonight, so I'm looking to buy this market tomorrow morning, and I have my eyes on a seller failure with a hidden channel tomorrow. And of course, the euro is range-bound with a big old triangle pattern tonight, so I have my eyes on the edges of this range, and we're looking to use those two try failure opportunities tomorrow morning. Boy, I get a lot of ranges here tonight, get a couple very strong trends on the E-minis. We're going to cover everything here in just a few seconds, but before we jump in to put the plan together for Tuesday's session, I want to remind you, you can find a detailed description of this entire trading strategy written out right here on my blog at sidewaysmarkets.com. I'll leave the link in the description of this video. Also, if you have any questions about anything covered in this video tonight, please remember to post them in the comment section below. And if you like what you see, please help support this channel by subscribing, and when you do, hit the bell icon so you get notified every time I post another video. And don't forget, if your goal is to become a consistently profitable trader, you can get your transformation started by going right to our homepage here at sidewaysmarkets.com and joining our mailing list. Don't forget, you can also download all the charts from tonight's video. There's a button right below the video tonight on our blog. And if you have any questions about anything covered tonight, again, you can post them in the comment section below, or you can always pick up the phone and call that toll-free number or use that live support tool in the upper right-hand corner. So let's get this ball rolling forward here for us tonight on the newsletter. Let's jump into that economic news calendar. Let's get that schedule ready here for tomorrow, and then we'll grab some charts and we'll put the plan together. Now, of course, we are just about finished with the month of October, and it's important that you remember today, of course, the 29th, tomorrow the 30th, and of course, All Hallows Eve, right? Halloween, the end of the month, is on the 31st. Now, any time that we talk about the end of the month, we always know we're going to see an uptick in volatility and usually a decrease in volume as we go into the end of the month. A lot of traders, a lot of wise traders, will be protecting their capital as they go into the end of the month. That's where the volume will dry up a little bit. But at the same time, though, you've also got a lot of reckless traders out there that are trying to either make up for lost time, or maybe they've had a great month and they're trading a little bit more aggressively. So we do expect to see some extra volatility, right, and a little bit more illiquid markets as we go into the end of the week. Not to worry, I'll be right there with you every step of the way in our trade room to make sure that you know what's tradable and what's not. But you want to make sure, though, as you're going into the end of this week, just be aware you're probably going to see some pretty volatile markets as we finish up, right, this 10th month of the year. Now, of course, tomorrow is Tuesday, so zooming in here now on tomorrow's news, we don't have anything on the U.S. session, but as you can see here tomorrow, though, we do have quite a bit here coming out in the overnight London session. So for euro and for gold, you definitely want to be watching with the GDP from our friends in Italy at 5 o'clock, and then they got the GDP flash and the economic sentiment tomorrow at 6 a.m. So we are definitely expecting to see some big market-moving events before the U.S. session opens up and before we get out of bed right here in the U.S. If you're trading in Europe, you want to be aware of those tomorrow morning. At the same time here, we got that CPI number out of Germany at 9 o'clock Eastern time, right? That is also something we're watching for the euro and the gold tomorrow as well. So it could definitely be a pretty busy day here for gold and euro traders here tomorrow. As far as the U.S. session goes, there really isn't much on the schedule. You'll notice here we got the Case-Shiller home prices and consumer confidence. They're not that big market moving events, so we just want to be aware of them. But again, I'm not going to expect too many fireworks out of those. The big news tomorrow is at 9 o'clock, right? And of course 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock, and 9 o'clock for all you European market traders. The euro, right, and the gold, of course, will be affected by that as well. So that's the plan for tomorrow. Don't forget, end of the month, increase volatility. And again, no major news in the U.S. session. Speaking of the U.S. session, we're going to open up our trade room tomorrow morning at 8 o'clock Eastern time. And we're going to use this plan tonight, right? The goal tonight is to outline the plan so we know the plan for tomorrow morning when we get together in our trade room. Now, starting off tonight, we got crude oil, then we'll go to E-minis, S&P and NASDAQ, then over to the gold, and we'll wrap up, of course, as always, on the euro. Starting off tonight on oil, crude is bearish with a triangle or a range, a bearish channel, and a measured move on the chart tonight. The bears definitely have the momentum, but we're trading at the low of this weekly range. You can definitely see, if I zoom out a little bit more here, right, you can easily see this is one big, right, overall bear market, but we've been sitting in this range here for quite some time now, right, since last Tuesday. So we know the market is very much balanced with a short-term bear bias. You can easily see this momentum is moving lower. So momentum is definitely too strong right now to be buying down here, right? That's what we like to do at the low of a range. We want to buy the low of a range, right? So here's our range. We want to sell the high and we want to buy the low. The problem is the momentum right now is way too strong right now to start buying. So my plan is to wait for the sellers to try twice to keep this trend going, then look for buying opportunities into those stops using the two try failure pattern tomorrow morning. Now, this is a relatively easy plan. It's a range bound market. We want to buy low, sell high, and it doesn't really matter if it's a range like this. You'll see a couple of those tonight, right? That's a range, or maybe you see it as a range like this, right? This will also be a range, triangles, right, and rectangles. No matter what we have, whether it be a triangle or a rectangle, I want to sell high, I want to buy low, and to do that, we're going to use a simple pattern, which is called the two-try failure pattern. In other words, I'm going to let the market try to break out once, I'll let it try twice, and then we'll sell back down. Opposite side, same thing, once, twice, and then we'll buy back up. Now, there are a lot of different nuances to this, and we'll go over that a lot more detail in our classroom sessions, and I teach a lot of it in a free trading class, which I'll link up to in a moment. But really, at this point, we've got this strong move down, and that's our first try outside this range. We're now expecting to see a second try, and then we can look for that buy going higher. Now, if you want a good example of this on the opposite side, look on the upper left-hand corner, see how we go up, we pull back, we try again, and then we come collapsing back down. So that is a similar pattern to what we're looking for at these lows. I'm going to remove these arrows here to kind of keep it simpler here right now. But bottom line is, we have that nice strong move down off right outside the range. That qualifies now as the first attempt, right, to break out of that range. Now what I'm looking for is one of two kind of variations of this two try. The first one would be, which is the most reliable, is going to be a big second try down followed by a failure setup at the moving average. Failure setup, right, to be a buyer back up. In other words, we wait for the sellers now once, twice. They then get their job done, and then we look for those sellers now coming in at the moving average, and we're buying into their failure, right? That's a two try with a major second try. Now, once we have that, look for the move back up into the range. A second option here would be, let's say that we don't get that major two try. Let's now say we go back and we see what I call a nested two try, which would be a one try, up a second try, and I like to look for a trap here off of that low. This we call a nested two try. Now we have the major one try, and then inside of that attempted major second try, which you can see in this example we don't get, we get one and two from there. And you'll notice while I'm drawing this, I don't want to be trading in the range here. I want to be getting in just outside that range. So that's why we're going to look for that trap pattern as we go. And you're going to want to pay attention to this little pattern right here, because this pattern will be very useful on the S&P and the NASDAQ, which we'll talk about in just a moment. So it's pretty simple, right? We got one try looking for two tries and back up in. One try looking for two tries and then back down in. And then again, there's a couple variations, right? There's the major two try, the one, two. We get that lower low, right? Then we get that failure and back up. Or we have what I call the nested two try, which is the first try down, and then it's the one try to try with that trap low, right, for that buy back up. Again, we're not getting that major to try. We have to then look for those bears to try twice, right, this nested to try inside, right, of that first try. And the same thing would go for the upside, right? And again, you can see a good example right here, right? We saw as it goes up, one try, major to try, failure, back down in. We'll look at the same thing going higher. One try, major to try, failure, right? Failure and back in. Or it's that one try nested to try, right? With that trap, right? With that trap going back in. Now, I know I've covered a lot of this right now, and I know there's a lot to learn with these two try rules, and they're really, really powerful patterns. So here's what I want to do, especially for all the first timers out here this afternoon. It'd be much easier if I show you what a two try, a major two try, and a nested two try looks like. So here's what I'll do. Let's put a free trading class in the upper right-hand corner. You'll see that little link will pop up there in the upper right-hand corner. Grab that free class. It'll walk you through all the technical analysis tools that I use, including all these two try setups. I'll also put it in the description of the YouTube video. And if you're on the blog here right now, there's a big red button right below the video tonight. Grab that big red button below video and just register there. And that way, right, you'll be able to learn all of these patterns. And don't forget, when you register for the free course, make sure you check your email, check your spam folder. Sometimes these confirmation emails, they get sent off into the spam folder. I got to thank Google and Yahoo for that. Not much I can do about that. So if you do request that class, make sure you check your spam and your junk and your promotions folder. That way to make sure you have it. So we're going to stay with the middle, right? Stay away from that middle. We want to go one try, two try, back up, up, one try, two try, back down. One of the most common questions I get, though, is what does a breakout look like, right? How would we know when this range is broken? Well, I have a tool that I use, a pattern, right? It's called the 1-2-3 breakout. And that 1-2-3 breakout, just like the name suggests, goes 1-2-3 breakout. Or if we go back to the highs here now, 1-2-3 breakout. The bottom line is, if you look left at some of these examples here, for example, back here, we saw this strong move higher. It held the pullback, but it just couldn't keep going, right? It kind of fizzled out with the two try rule, obviously, and failed back down into that trading range. We expect the same thing to happen here, right? We expect them to try again, and we expect them to kind of fizzle out here and go back up into that trading range. What would it look like for a breakout of this range, the downside? Well, we already have one strong move lower. That counts for one. Now let's go back to the moving average. That's step two. And then step three would be a strong move outside of that, right? That's the key. It's got to be a real strong move through that moving average. Again, go back and look at this example. They got the one, they got the two, but they didn't get the three, right? The three wasn't a big jump. And you'll see this happens all the time on ranges. So what you want to wait for is wait for that strong move down outside the range. Then that pullback to the moving average. Now this is go time for the sellers. If they show us they mean business and they jump off that moving average, now we know the market is broken out. And now we can do is mark up that low, find the new hidden channel, and look to sell off the high of that hidden channel. Now, hidden channels are another one of my favorite patterns. They're great for, trending markets, range-bound markets, reversals. And again, if you want to learn more about how to find those hidden channels, grab that free course below the video on the blog or find that link in the upper right-hand corner. You'll find the information icon, very easy to find if you're on the YouTube channel. So now we know how we're buying and we're selling using the two-try rule, and we also know how we're going to look for a breakout, right? A 1, 2, 3 breakout. Mark that high, mark those highs, find that channel, and we're looking to buy right the low of that channel. And again, don't worry, we're going to do all this together tomorrow morning at 8 o'clock Eastern time. So get started with that free course and then get registered as a brand new member, and we'll see you guys tomorrow morning. Now, we talked about that two-try trap, that nested two-try, and we're going to see a great example of this now right on the S&P. The S&P is bullish with a hidden channel, a bear channel, and a measured move on the chart tonight. Yes, today's price action was mostly bearish, but the way price bounced off of that low, strong push through that moving average, the momentum is just too strong to try selling this market until we can get back moving that momentum lower again tomorrow, right? The challenge, however, is going to be anticipating that there's probably going to be some sellers here who are wanting to try to sell this market lower. So we don't want to buy up here. That would be ludicrous. That'd be buying high. We want to buy after we see those sellers try a couple times to retest these lows. Let those sellers get open positions. Let them wrap that rope right around their neck so that once they fail, we get that short covering rally, right? Going back up to retest those highs tomorrow. Now, what I want to talk about here for a second is one of the most important lessons we talk about every day in our trade room, and that is how to use the moving average. Now, I want to start by looking up top here, and you can see how once the market turned, the buyers could no longer keep the market above the moving average. Okay, notice how once the market was bearish, every time it popped above the moving average, the sellers sold it back down. Now, this wasn't just today on the S&P. Look at the oil, right? Look at the oil. Every time, back to the old chart, every time the market went above the moving average, what happened? It could barely get above it. It could barely get above it. Every time it went above that moving average, it got slapped back down. And you can see how it was the one try, two try, failure back down. So the bottom line is that when the market's bearish, it'll have a very difficult time staying above the moving average. Okay? When we see a situation like this now on the S&P, look what we're seeing right there. Does this market look like it's having any trouble staying above the moving average? No. In fact, it looks like the trouble has shifted now. It looks like the burden is now on the side of the sellers. Because from what I can see, there was nobody even there to sell that moving average. Right now, I'm sure some people out there would say, well, yeah, of course, because you know they're waiting for this halfway pullback. Sure. But this is one of the big reasons why I don't use Fibonacci very much in my trading, because far too many people will put that halfway point and say, I'm going to sell at whatever Fibonacci retracement it is. The problem, though, is that when we see this big, strong V bottom here, if you're trying to blindly sell into this level of resistance right now, you are stepping into a freight train. Right. And if we can see now some sellers now, I'm anticipating you're going to see some sellers here trying to sell into that. I'm getting ready to buy right into their stops, because that will probably be the easiest trade here for tomorrow. So this is one very, very important way that I use the moving average every day. And that is I look at the way the markets are responding to it. Once we saw the market turn bearish, the buyers couldn't get anything accomplished. But then look what happened. We make that big move down, we bounce back up, and wait a second. Why didn't we at least see a one try, two try, and a run back down? Oh, I know why. Because the market is now bullish. So that's the easy part. We know the market is bullish. But now we want to use that vitamin E strategy we talked about from last week. Remember that from last week? I kind of joked around by saying, did you take your vitamin E? What was vitamin E? empathy, right? Yeah, vitamin E, empathy, one of the most important skills you can have as a trader. And believe it or not, empathy can be practiced and it can be learned. We go over a very simple routine to build empathy every day in our trade room by trying to put ourselves in the shoes of the opposite side. And we do that by listening to the story. I don't want to go into too much detail on this, but the bottom line is put yourself in the shoes of the sellers right now. Right? If you were a seller right now, what would you be trying to do? Well, I would, if I was a rookie at this and I watched my newsletter a little bit, I'd be looking now for a two-try failure, right? A two-try failure pattern to sell back down. The problem, though, is momentum isn't very strong right now for the sellers, is it? In fact, it's more bullish than bearish. So that's what I'm looking for. I'm looking for these sellers now to try to run this lower. And then I'm looking for a buy going back up to retest the high. Now, here's what it really looks like. A lot of times what happens is we get this move down. We go up through the moving average, right? Through that moving average, we short little pullback, little shallow pullback, we go higher here. Oftentimes this, and if you're a member of the trade room, what do we call these? We call these grind breaks, right? We call these grind breaks. That's the nickname that we use for them, these little grind breaks. There's a lot more to this than what I'm teaching you right now, but that little trap low, if you're a client of mine, it's the same thing as those grind breaks we talk about for those little micro channels. So what I'm looking for now is I want to see us go below that low. That's where I want that buy. That's where I want that buy. That momentum is a little bit more bullish than bearish now. Let those bears, right? Let them try once, let them try twice, and let's see if we can get this thing right going higher here. So as I go zooming in now, again, I'm anticipating now with that momentum flying higher, there's that little shallow pullback right there. Now I know I want that bingo, right? I want that trap, right? I want that trap. That's the plan if we can get that pullback, right? That pullback, trap low below the 2630 area. Look for that nice strong signal closing above the moving average, and we're good to go. I'm not even going to worry about this falling resistance because it won't stand a chance. The bears will push right on through it because of that short covering rally. Now, what if we keep going higher here? What if we don't pull back? What if this thing keeps going higher? This is definitely a possibility here for tomorrow. It may turn into a bit of a channel here, right? Some sort of spike in channel. If that's the case, the plan stays the same. If it's a spike in channel, now we look for those prior swings. And again, we look for that trap low. Now, if we can get this trap low, we should be able to as well, if I can kind of draw this out here a little bit. If we can get that trap low now, trap low into a two-try failure, right, into a move higher. So what you're looking for now is that trap pattern, right, trap low into a one-try, two-try, right, that sets up now. So trap low into that one try, two try failure pattern, right? You'll notice I'm trying to draw this little hidden channel here, right? And that can be used as support as we go higher. So the bottom line is we are bullish with the momentum right now for the bulls. I'm looking to buy low. I've got this one little short-term pullback for that little trap low, right? Going back up. If we don't, if it keeps on going higher here, not much changes. I'm still going to look for that deep trap into a two try now. Then we could look for that run going back up, right, to retest that high. So get some great opportunities here to be a buyer. Another option here would be, what if we go sideways, right? If we go sideways up here, if we start seeing the market go sideways, it's a bull market into that sideways range. One try, two try. And we talked about, right, that two try pattern, right? It could be that major two try, one try, two try, then back up. Or maybe that nested two try, right? One try, two try, that nested two try, which we talked about on oil earlier on. Easier, right? No matter what, though, we're looking to buy below the low of that range. And you can learn so much more about these trap patterns, two try failure patterns. It's all covered in that free trading course, either below the video in the blog or in the upper right hand corner here on YouTube. Now, one question I bet you're asking right now is how do we turn bearish? right? What does a bear market look like? There's a couple different things I'm looking for to call this a bear market. One would be a strong move back down, right? That's pretty easy. If we see this thing run back lower and it really pushes lower here, now at this point, we know they're trying to go back down to retest that low. The problem is we don't want to sell very low down here. So rather than trying to sell low, anytime we have the, anytime we're bearish, but we're running right into a level of support, now we look for those traps. We talked about this, right? Pullbacks versus traps last week on the newsletter, right? If we do see that strong move down, again, you'll see it. It'll collapse right back down, resist that temptation to sell down there, and focus on selling high with traps. We talked about this last Thursday night into Friday's trading session last week in the newsletter, where when I'm running out of open space, I want to use those trap patterns instead of pullback patterns. And again, you can learn more about those trap patterns either as a client or as part of that free trading class as we go lower. All right, guys. Now the big question will be, do we run back and bounce off that low? If we do, this becomes a range. And if this does become a range, then it's one try, two try, right? Those two try patterns we talked about earlier, right? Selling back off that high, selling the two try off of that high. Or if we keep going lower, right? If we keep going lower, let's find this now as a new channel, and we'll try to sell off the top of that channel. So as you can see, I've got a plan for you. The markets can be very complicated sometimes, but I got a great plan for us. And again, we're going to execute this plan right tomorrow morning. So right now, it's looking for that trap low, right back up, or does this turn into a spike in channel? Right, it's that trap, it's that two try and that go. Or do we run lower here, running lower, wait for that trap high, right, and sell back up? Or do we run and bounce and create a range? If that's the case, one try, two try, selling that second try back down. Or do we keep rolling through, right? And if that's the case here, if we roll to new lows here, now let's find that new channel, right? Let's draw in and sell off the top of that channel. So great plan setting up here for tomorrow. We know what we're looking for here. All we need now are the candlesticks to give us the patterns. Over here now to the Nasdaq. The Nasdaq is very similar. As you can see here, Nasdaq is bullish with a hidden channel and a measured move on the chart this evening. The session was mostly bearish today. As you can see, every time the market went above the moving average, they couldn't do anything with it. It kept on getting sold back down below that moving average again until look what happened here recently. Something's changed, right? We're no longer seeing sellers at the moving average anymore, are we? No. It looks like those bears are nowhere to be found, at least, right, at least for now. So we might be mostly bearish today, but this short covering rally, these sellers taking their profit and rallying off those lows, just has too much bullish momentum right now to be ignored. So rather than trying to sell this bounce higher, which I'm sure there are going to be a lot of bears that try that tomorrow, my plan is to wait for those sellers, let them try once, let them try twice, and then we'll look for that rally going back up to a measured move or possibly all the way up to that 7,000 big round number, which is pretty much where this party began here at the beginning of today's session. So a lot of this is going to be very, very similar we talked about on the S&P. The one thing about the NASDAQ is we don't really have much of a pullback right now. So the ideal scenario, honestly, would be something like this, a short pullback, right, and then that trap low. That would be, oh man, hopefully we get that tomorrow. That would be the ideal setup right there, right? Draw that channel off those highs, bring it up off that low, create that little hidden channel support. Man, that's going to be a great setup if we can get it. Because then if we can get that pattern, then we've got the bears trying once, the bears trying twice, they're trying at a higher price. It'll be a great pattern if we can get that pattern tomorrow. Another option would be a spike in channel, right? We spike up, we keep going, right? Nice narrow channel. What do we do here? We look left. We found those prior swings. We look for that deep pullback. That leads into a trap, into a two-try failure, into a buy, right? It's a trap low into a one-try, two-try failure pattern for a buy going back higher. And again, you'll notice I'm trying to find some sort of channel here, right, to use that channel as support. A lot of this is very similar to what we talked about on the S&P. Also, we are bullish right now. Watch and see if we go sideways here. If we start seeing this thing going sideways, we have a bull bias into that trading range. If that's the case, looking for one try, looking for two tries, and we look for that buy after that one, two try failure pattern going back up into that range. And again, we talked about the major two try, the nested two tries earlier on, right, on this afternoon's video. And again, it's a great example of how you can use the moving average. The moving average shows here right now, bears have it until they don't. And now we can easily see that momentum is too bullish now. Now we'll look for that trap low. So an easy way to use the moving average. You don't need a lot of fancy tools. Just learn how to use the simple tools that have been working for traders for almost a century now. Let's keep going. Nasdaq's good. We know the bear market real quickly, right? How does it turn bearish? It turns bearish with a strong move down, right? Strong move down. Then what? Don't sell down here. It's too low to sell there. You want to wait to get up, right, and sell with those traps. Because remember, anytime you're bearish, but you've got limited open space for support levels below you, it's best to skip the pullbacks and look to take the trap patterns. Again, we talked about that last week. Also, watch in case here we get that bounce off of that low. If we get the bounce off that low, not to worry, that becomes a bear range. One try, two try, failure back down in, right? Two try rule up those highs. And again, it'll look very similar to that, right? We'll go up one try, two try, and then back down we come. One try, two try, and then back down we come. And then don't forget, if we do collapse lower, everybody's talking about a bear market right now. If we do collapse lower here, right, no problem. We'll keep using this channel and we'll try to sell off the high of that channel, right? No need to worry. If we do go lower here and we confirm the bears want to keep control of this, that's fine by me. There's nothing wrong with that. If we don't get the buy here, we'll get the sell after we get the rotation. But for right now, though, way too much short-term bullishness for me to try selling this. I'm looking for that trap low to be that buyer here tomorrow morning. Let's keep going. Got the E-minis out of the way. How about some gold here now? Now, gold is another example of how we can use that moving average. Gold is bearish with a range, a spike in channel, and a measured move on the chart tonight. The bears have control because, as you can see, they can't hold it above the moving average. Right? See how that moving average works? It's very, very easy to use. Now that I can see the market is holding above that moving average, right, I know that this is not a bull momentum, right? I've got to be careful. The problem is, right, we're at the low of this weekly range, right? Go back in time here, and that's the range right from last week. So where are we? We're at the low of this range. We don't want to sell down here. Right? Remember, I said earlier, when you have a range-bound market, no matter what the bulls or bears are doing here, when a market goes sideways, we want to buy the low, we want to sell the high. I don't care what the old-school trading books or those rookies on YouTube tell you, but breakouts of ranges are not reliable trading opportunities. So what we're looking for here is we've got that trading range, and we're right down at the low of that range right now, a horrible place to be a seller. I want to be a buyer. But wait a second. How do we buy when the momentum is bearish right now? We have to let these bears, right, basically fail so we can buy into their stop losses and get that rally going higher here. So we got the strong move down, right? We know we have that strong move down here. Okay, that constitutes the first try. Now we're waiting for, and we talked about this earlier on crude oil, right? We get all the support down here. We get the measured move down here. We get the pendulum swing down here, right? So these are great support areas down here. We've got this one try going lower. We're looking for either a second try, a major second try, right? Into a failure, back up, right? So major one, two, into that failure, back up. And again, you can learn all about those failure patterns on that free trading class, which I've talked about a couple times already, right? Grab that free class. It's linked up in the description or it's below the video on the blog. So again, one option would be we got one try. It's a major two try into a failure back up, right? Failure at the moving average, that is. Okay, that's one option. Or, right, do we see a nested two try? A one, a two, right? And again, I like to look for that trap low, and that trap low will now give me one try, two try. And again, I call this a nested two try because it's inside of that first try. The ideal situation is you want to see it go down one, two, right, and then back up, get that lower low, because that ropes in all the sellers. It also puts us at that major support area and that measured move and that pendulum swing. So one try, two try, then as we go back to that moving average now, let those bears fail that pullback. That'll give you that pullback failure. Then we can look for that hidden channel pullback, and we can get that hidden channel pullback right off of that low. We'll talk more about hidden channel pullbacks inside that free trading course, as well as tomorrow, right, in the trade room. The bottom line, though, is if we don't get that, if it goes higher here, one try, two try, I like to get that little trap low, right, that trap low, or some level, right, of support, right? Sometimes we see them, they'll do this, well, they'll go one try, pull back, go, and then we can draw that trend line off, right, and grab it right there as well. The bottom line, though, is I'd like to get that trap, right? But again, if we don't get that major two try, I want to see that nested two try for that buy now going back up. So that's the plan there for the buyers on the gold. And again, we'll do a lot more work on the two try rule inside the classroom sessions and inside the free trading course. Now, what if this thing just runs higher here, right? What if it runs higher? If it runs higher here, look for a trap low, right? If it runs higher here, look for a trap low. I don't want to buy into the high of this range. And so if we just see this thing continue to take off here and it's not going to stop here, not going to pull back here for us, look for that trap, right? And look to buy that little trap low. What if we keep running, right? If we keep running all the way through the highs, wonderful. That's the first try. Let them try once, let them try twice. Do we get the major two try? If that's the case, right? Then it's the failure back down in, or do we see that one try and then one, two, trap and go, right, for that nested two try on the way back down into that trading range. The bottom line is stay away from that middle. Look to buy low with a two try for the sellers. Look to sell high, one try, two try for those bears. And again, if you see a strong move up, right, and you can get that one, two, that nested two try, you can sell that, right? But if you don't, one, wait for it, and then we let that failure take us back down from there. And I realize the two try rule has been very common lately. It seems like that's all we're doing right now, but it's because we have a lot of these ranges and a lot of these crazy volatile markets right now. But these are working really, really well every day in our trade room. And speaking of trade room, again, tomorrow morning, we'll be there tomorrow at 8 o'clock Eastern time if you want to come out and trade this whole plan with us. Let's keep going here. How about some euro wrapping up tonight here? Euro is sideways with a triangle, a hidden channel, and a measured move on the chart this evening. The momentum is neutral with both the bulls and the bears playing this market back and forth like a tennis match. So my plan is to buy the low, sell the high, and avoid the middle. And to do that, my goal is to use support levels such as the low of this hidden channel. If I go this trend line down, this hidden channel, that's going to be a support level. I can also use this measured move as a support level as well. But as I always remind you guys about a triangle pattern, it's all about the swings. When it comes to a triangle, it's all about the edges. The edges of that triangle are usually where you're going to find the most tradable opportunities. So we know the market's sideways. We can easily see that moving average, right? And here's a good example how to use that moving average. We talked about using the moving average today on the previous charts. Well, now you can see the buyers can't hold it above. The sellers can't hold it below. The buyers can't hold it above. The sellers can't hold it below. You can easily see that nobody is taking control around that moving average right now. That would be your sign. This is a range-bound market. It's a neutral market. It's a balanced market. It's a sideways market. Whatever you want, whatever term you want to use to describe it, right? Neither side of this is really taking control right now. So we know this market's a sideways market, which means we want to use that two try rule, right? We go up, one try, two try, back down in. Again, one try, two try, back down in. One try, two try, back down in. You can see this two try rule working over and over again here on the euro. Now all we need is to get that thing moving lower. I want to see us one, pull back to the moving average, twice, and then back up in. One, pull back to that moving average two, and then right back in. We talked about the major two tries and the nested two tries at the beginning of this video, so keep that in mind tomorrow. And again, I'll be doing it with you tomorrow in the trade room, so don't worry. The only thing I'm concerned about here is the middle of this range, and you'll notice we're getting narrower here as we go. One of the key components to a triangle is that as we start getting narrower for that triangle, the breakouts of these ranges start getting larger because they're trying to free up more space. So don't be surprised if we see a relatively strong move down, pull back to that moving average, second try off the moving average, and then we get that nice rally higher here, even after a very strong first leg down, one try, two try, then we're buying into those stops for that rally going higher. Same thing above, right? We go higher here, strong move up. Don't get fooled by that strong move up. Let those buyers sort of buy that pullback. Then we know we're looking for those bears, those buyers to fail, so we can then sell into their stops for that move going back down into that range. And again, if you want to see literally hundreds of examples of real two-try patterns, right, directly off the charts, grab that free trading class. It's linked up below the video tonight on the blog or in the upper right-hand corner in that information icon if you're on our YouTube channel. Boy, I had a great day today. We're looking forward to another great day tomorrow. I know these markets can be a little bit tough right now, but that's okay. All you need is a plan, a process to execute that plan, and what I call the trader's mindset. And we're gonna make sure we cultivate that trader's mindset every day together in our trade room. I've got a great plan for you. I look forward to coaching right along with you tomorrow morning in the trade room to make sure you're executing that plan correctly. Don't forget, you can call me anytime you want with that toll-free number right next to my ugly mug. Our advanced classes are the most popular. They include all-inclusive lifetime memberships, and of course, access to our trade room. And if you have any questions, right, call the office, join the free trial, right, or it's linked up right in the description if you're here on YouTube. As always, it is great to be here with you guys and gals. We'll see you guys tomorrow morning, 8 o'clock Eastern time. If we don't see you guys tomorrow morning, come back and see us again tomorrow night in the newsletter, and we'll do it all again. My name is Joseph. Be well out there. Be nice to each other, will ya? And be here next time. Adios, amigos. Bye-bye for now.